Welcome to the Awakening Podcast Network. Get ready for an inspiring audio from this cutting-edge voice. You can find more podcasts at awakeningpodcasts.com.
A reset of the prophetic movement is upon us. The second wave of prophets is rising in this hour. We stand at the edge of a new era in the prophetic. We're gathering the international prophetic community at the Global Prophetic Center, a hub for prophetic training, prophetic labs, summits, networks, and lighthouses. It's time for prophets to go deeper. It's time for seers to soar. It's time for prophetic voices to rise up and decree what says the Spirit of God with accuracy that causes the world to pay attention. The Global Prophetic Center offers proven prophetic systems and structures to equip you to walk worthy of your calling and to prophesy with precision, boldness, diplomacy, and wisdom. Get hands-on training and mentoring in a safe environment that breeds true prophetic community and learning. Receive impartation and activation. Sharpen your gift and avoid prophetic pitfalls. Get commissioned. Get networked. Get sent out with the word of the Lord in your mouth and the confidence to release it. Begin your journey today by applying at globalpropheticcenter.com.
Do you need a healing in your body? Well, you're in the right place, because today we're going to learn about how to get healed and how to stay healed. And the good news is that Jesus is here, which means the power to heal is here. I'm Robert Hotchkin, sitting in for Patricia King on this episode of Everlasting Love TV. And joining me is Joan Hunter.
Yay, I always love coming on this program.
We love having you. Thank you for coming back. I'm very excited about this topic because I love seeing God work healing miracles. I love seeing people set free from sickness and disease. And you see this all over the world. And today,
every day.
Yeah, every day. Every day, wherever you go. Mm-hmm. I mean, just in the green room, you were praying for a knee to be healed. And everywhere mm-hmm. you go, you're seeing that healing anointing rise up. You operate in the power to heal that is Christ within us.
Absolutely. And what's neat is that it's available for everybody.
Right.
It's not just for Joan, because it's Jesus on the inside of me that heals through me. He's looking for a good pair of hands that would love to go and to do his business all over.
I think we're coming into a time. Well, we're always in a time, but I think there's going to be an emphasis, because there's such an emphasis on harvest right now. And I think the power to heal is going to be critical to that.
Absolutely.
Because so many people, when they get that healing, so many people who didn't agree, all of a sudden are going to go, whoa, something really just happened. I need to change how I think about Jesus.
And well, a lot of people believe, well, they know that Jesus is the healer. But there are a lot of other faiths that are like Buddha and things like that. But you know, when people say, well, you have to be a Christian to get healed. No, you don't. And so I recently was at a church that was called All Nations Church out of the country. And I found out that all religions were welcome. Literally, all religions were welcome. Not sure if the pastor was even saved or not. And we had about 150 people there. And it was a very interesting experience, mm-hmm. to say the least. I had no idea what All Nations actually meant, because I know of another church called All Nations. It's great.
Right.
And so went in, and I'm like, okay, Jesus, nobody here knows you. What an opportunity.
What an incredible opportunity.
And I mean, every denomination, from Sikh to Hindu, you name it. And every one of them got healed.
Come on. I mean, this
dramatically healed.
The scripture that God put on my heart before we started was that he anointed Paul to work notable and remarkable miracles. And it was a hallmark of his ministry. And mm-hmm. we need to see that arise in the body again. We've got some great examples like you, but I'm hungry to see everybody walking in this, because Jesus healed them all, and he wants to do mm-hmm. it again today through those of us who are willing to believe. So let's talk about your new book, Power to Heal, because the first thing we need the body of Christ healthy and strong, and then we can go out and we can freely give what we have freely received.
Absolutely.
And I want you to know, those of you who have been challenged by long-term sickness, illness, and attacks like that, that the reason I believe the enemy has attacked you so hard is because you're called not only to operate in the fullness of health and life, vigor and vitality, but to release that. And I believe you're not only going to get your breakthrough today, but you're going to be released into the power to heal others in Jesus' name.
Absolutely. And many of my books have been birthed out of personal experience. You know, in the year 2000, diagnosed, you know, had to go through divorce, went, got diagnosed with breast cancer, but my heart was a wreck, broken heart syndrome, et cetera. Long story short, you know, I went and I said, God, I can live without a breast, but I can't live with a broken heart. So I went after getting my heart healed, got rid of the trauma, the stress, the worry, betrayal, abandonment, and the list goes on. And so after a while, I thought, I need to go back to the oncologist to see what we need, what she recommends at this point. So I go back in, and 2 hours later, they're looking everywhere, everywhere that they can look, and there's no cancer. They can't figure out what happened to the cancer.
So you were focused on the healing of the soul,
yes,
the healing of the broken heart, and in the midst of going through that with the Lord, the physical healing just
happened. I learned how to starve sickness.
Tell us more about that.
That is like so awesome.
That's
because,
huge.
See, we feed it by what the doctor says. You've got cancer. You've got 2 years to live. You've got your relative who goes, do you have everything in order? You know, I'm like, come on, let's stop that. And I was very careful who I told. I didn't even tell the girls because they had just lost their dad.
Okay.
You know,
okay.
And so I called my parents. We prayed. I prayed. That was all I did. And then I went after getting my heart healed. And as ferocious as a piranha is, and actually use this as an example, that as ferocious as a piranha is, you can withhold food from the piranha and it will die.
Right.
And we've got to withhold food from our sickness.
Wow.
So that the sickness will die. And I learned about how to get rid of trauma. This is a real strong point where I teach. And getting rid of the trauma that opens up the door for sickness.
Okay.
One of Patricia's favorite things is she goes, in a service, she goes, okay, anybody with fibromyalgia, run up here. And I think the most was like 19. And so they all lined up, and it was a trauma that brought it on from like a year before they were diagnosed with fibromyalgia. So at that point, I go down, I pray for every one of them right in front of Patricia, and all 19 of them were instantly healed.
I've been in some of those meetings,
yes,
where you've prayed specifically for that, and I've watched that anointing flow.
It's
and
so
the
amazing.
Looks on the people's faces. Some of them have had that chronic pain.
35,
for,
50
exactly,
years,
and
then
all
free.
Of a sudden it's gone.
And they have insomnia, they have chronic fatigue. I mean, literally, everything is wiped out because of the root of the trauma.
Yeah. And I know a couple instances where people almost didn't come forward because they'd been prayed for so many times.
Absolutely.
Against the chronic fatigue, against the fibromyalgia, and yet you had that extra key that God had revealed to you about how to starve the sickness by eliminating the trauma.
We did a mentorship in Dallas with Patricia and Wendy Walters, and I came in for one of the speakers. And so one of the pastor's wives was there, and she goes, everybody's prayed for me.
Yes,
you know,
everybody's right,
prayed for me.
Right.
And between her and Annabelle Walnow and Wendy, they drug her up to the front and to make her get up to the front and me pray for her.
Wow.
I prayed for her. She was instantly healed. I've ministered at that church, and they're like going, everybody came out because they have seen her crippled,
yes,
in every way for years, trying to maintain even just to be able to talk because she had so much pain.
Wow.
And so everybody came because it's like, if they can heal Susie,
yeah,
actually her name is Curtis.
Okay.
Okay, so her name is Curtis. And to heal her literally completely set the church on fire.
Well, it's such a witness. I remember years ago, as a brand new Christian, I got to be part of a healing crusade in Africa. And we were in this little tiny part of Ethiopia. And I think it was the second night or the third night, a little boy who'd been deaf his entire life for 5 years got healed, and his ears popped open. He could hear. The next night, his entire village walked
absolutely
there because they knew for 5 years this young man could not hear a word. The next day, he shows up. They say good morning to him. He hears it, says it back, and they're like, wait, you can hear now? And he says, yeah, there were all these crazy people in a field last night that prayed for me in the name of Jesus. And then all of a sudden, the entire village shows up. The healing power, the power to heal, is such an amazing way of bearing witness of Jesus.
Absolutely. And in this book, I talk about the power of your words.
Okay.
Okay. And the power of words spoken over you.
Okay.
That you'll never get well. You're going to have to learn to live with this pain.
Right.
What a horrible statement. How do you learn to live with pain? You can't. And people learn how to numb the pain just because that's just the way of life. And so it tells you how to get rid of all the heart issues and different things like that. And word curses, generational curses brought through the bloodline. What about a blood transfusion? Tells you how to get rid of all that kind of stuff. And a lot of the teachings that goes around is dealing with soul ties. Well, when I got divorced, they said, renounce the soul ties. I renounced the soul ties. 2 years later, it dawned on me, I didn't go in a soul tie. I went in a covenant. I was still in covenant with everything he was doing. It was like, yuck, okay? So at that point, I said, let me just, I renounced the covenant that I made with George. I call him generic George. And that I made with George, we're no longer married. So I renounced the covenant. Anything bad that came in through it, take it from me now in Jesus' name. Boom. You know, and like, I'm writing a book right now, should be out sometime this year. And it's going to talk about the different medications that have actual human DNA in it.
Wow.
Like the shot of Rogam, if you have Rh negative, you know, that Rogam, I knew that one. But there's somewhere between 50 and 100 shots that are well known, not all the shots, but that are well known that have blood or human DNA in it.
Mm.
And I have a friend who had Rh negative, got the Rogam shot, and all of a sudden she started getting rheumatoid arthritis at 40. She's like, there's no rheumatoid arthritis in my family. She said this prayer, and it went, boom, just
but
like that.
But there was in the bloodline of what was in the shot.
Yeah, absolutely.
And she was taking that in.
Yep.
Wow.
Yeah, it's amazing, that power. And then body part transplants and, you know, and different things like that.
Well, there's so much going on in medical science that can be a blessing. But then within that, there can be these hidden things that the enemy can ride in on. And yet, we don't need to be afraid of any of it, but we do need to be aware and empowered to heal.
Pray over the blood before it goes in and pray over it after it's gone in. Because, see, in America, who donates most of the blood? It's derelicts and homeless people to get more money for drinking or whatever. So the blood is still the same, but what it does, and I've got medically documented cases where people woke up craving alcohol. Mm. And woke up out of surgery cussing.
Who had never wrestled with that before.
Who had never cussed in their life before.
Wow. And after the blood transfusion they got during surgery, all of a sudden.
And then they come to service and find out, what's going on here? And what I talk about is cellular memory. And the cells remember the pain. Like, for example, this one guy the other day, he had pain in his shoulder. And everybody's prayed for it. I said, but I haven't. And so I said, when did you do it? He said, well, I fell. And they prayed for the shoulder, but I prayed for the trauma and cellular memory to go. Totally, completely healed. Literally, instantly like
right
that.
On.
He's like, wow, what happened? I said, you got healed. And he's like, I can't believe it. I said, well, you wanted me to pray for you. You know, you're expecting a miracle, so here's your miracle, you know? And, but anyway, And that was amazing. Then another lady saw me on Sid Roth, and she had a cornea transplant. And what happened is after the cornea, she had one left eye. She was laying and she was shut her eyes, and there were people looking at her. She's like, I don't know these people. This is really weird.
Oh my goodness.
And so long story short is she saw me on Sid Roth talking about cellular memory. She goes to the camera, television, lays her hand on the camera or the TV, gets totally completely healed. They all go away. And I've actually met her since then. It's all the people that were looking at the person dying before they died.
Amazing.
Even the cornea could remember that.
Wow.
Power in what you see through your eyes.
As Joan was sharing that, the Lord gave me a word of knowledge of somebody watching, a woman watching, and you've wondered what happened to your husband with a massive personality shift. And I think right now the Lord is highlighting to you the surgery that he received, and this is going to be a key for you interceding. Don't go anywhere, because when we come back from the break, Joan Hunter is going to share more testimonies and more about the power to heal. We're back with Joan Hunter talking about the power to heal. And I want you to get ready, because as she shares more testimony and more insight from her book, Power to Heal, we believe that the healing power of Jesus is going to break out and meet you right where you are. Joan, these testimonies are amazing, and I know you know this, but the power of testimony is it stirs
Absolutely.
Up the faith within us. The spirit of prophecy is the testimony of Jesus. So I want to ask you to share a few more testimonies that have to do with what you reveal in the power to heal before we go into having you minister to the viewers.
It's so amazing, the power to heal, the revelation that's in here. A guy came up in the service the other day, and he says he needed two knee replacements and two new rotator cuffs. I said, okay, no problem. And he says, says, I'm losing my mind. I said, okay. So I prayed. He got, I mean, totally completely got two new knees, got two new shoulders, absolutely wow. dramatically healed. It was awesome. I said, now, when did you feel like you started losing your mind? And he says, about 6 years ago. And I said, okay, what happened 6 years ago? He said, I divorced my wife. I said, okay. And I said, did you ever say during that time that my wife is driving me crazy? You're driving me crazy. He goes, all the time. I said, guess what? Your words worked.
Wow.
And he's like, wow, I never thought about it. And so I had to renounce the words in Jesus' name, cut those words off in Jesus' name. And all of a sudden, I was just like, he just woke up out of a stupor, literally instantly like that. Wow. He was totally healed. You know, we got to be careful,
right?
You know, of what's happening, and you know, and like,
and the words we speak. We've talked about this before. There's power mm-hmm. in life and death in the tongue, and we need to understand that our words create, and they create blessing by agreeing with the word of God, or they can create curse mm-hmm. by cursing ourselves, like mm-hmm. he did, declaring, "You're driving me crazy."
And there's a lady when I recorded the School of Supernatural here with Patricia King University, okay, and we had a lady come up, and her name is Sandy. And I know you know who Sandy
yeah, sure.
is because she goes
yeah.
to Shiloh Church. And she was one of my examples about power of words. Now, her husband had died.
Right.
Okay.
And away.
And she said, and I asked her one day, I said, did you ever say, I can't live without you? I love mm-hmm. you so much. She goes, oh, yeah, all the time. I said, that's a word curse. When he died, death, it was an agreement and covenant with death that you're going to die. And this started happening. This started happening with her body. Depression happened. She didn't want to live,
right.
you know, all this kind of stuff. And she's like, this is not my personality. She's part of the intercessory prayer team here, you know, and it was just like she couldn't pray. She couldn't do anything.
Right.
And so we actually prayed for her, had her renounce those words. I love you with, you know, but I renounce those words
yes.
in Jesus' name. I am going to live without you.
Yes.
And it's so neat how we walked out through the final stages of that for her to be completely free, and the releasing of the cremains and everything was just, it was so amazing what God did. But it was when she said that, joy, I mean, her body just...
Life came back.
Yep,
her,
life yeah. came back. You can see it. It's actually, mm-hmm. you can see her being transformed on the video.
Wow.
And how her whole life is completely changed and came into who she is today. She got her joy back. She got the power back. She got free of depression. She got rid of this ache and pain and this and that and everything. Just totally, completely free.
Amazing.
And it's the power of your words because, you know, Michael Bolton, can't live if living was without you. Renounce those words.
Right, right. It's a romantic idea, but it is a
yeah,
word curse.
Yeah, yeah, don't do this. It's, you know, it's like a death wish, and
yeah.
people don't think about that.
Mm-mm.
But so oftentimes, one spouse dies, the other one dies right after
right.
that. It's because of that.
Wow.
You know, and like for another example, Debbie Reynolds. When Carrie died, she says, I can't live without you.
Her daughter,
within
yeah.
24 hours, Debbie Reynolds died of broken heart syndrome.
Oh my gosh.
And the power of her words, I can't
wow.
live without you, went to her, boom, had a heart attack and died.
Amazing.
So, I mean, even in the secular world,
right.
words are
sure.
important.
Sure.
And very, very powerful. Another topic in here is getting rid of stress and trauma.
Okay.
And because everybody has stress, but what do you do with the stress? You can allow the stress to, you know, hurt you. You know, you get worried over your kids. Like, this teaches you how to fix your kids, how to fix your husband, and fix your wife. Throw her in there, too. But the thing is, we try so hard to do it our way
right.
instead of do it God's way.
Right.
And this will do it, and it's absolutely phenomenal. Quick little testimony.
Yeah, more testimony.
Yeah,
awesome.
This is awesome. I said, Father, I can't fix my daughter, one of my daughters. I lay her on your altar. I release her to you. Father, send somebody to her to minister to her.
Mm-hmm.
I'm mom. I'm not Joan Hunter with them. I'm mom or grandma. I'm not the evangelist and I don't preach. I'm mom. They need a mother. Okay. So the next week, somebody came into her place of business and died.
Mm.
They came and they're going, somebody died in the lobby. You know, so she came out and she was the only one that knew CPR and brought Patricia back to life.
Okay.
And so it was so cool. Well, her name was there because we had all the information. So she went to the hospital and would check up on her. She goes, Mom, I think she's charismatic. And I went, this is before FaceTime. I said, oh, really? And I'm going, I got so excited. And so the next day, I said, take her some of my books. She got some books at the house. Take her some of my books. So she said, well, do you know who Charles or Frances Hunter are? And she goes, oh, yeah, and they have a daughter named Joan. She goes, that's my mom. So they would meet for lunch, and Patricia would preach Jesus to her.
Wow.
And she's gone on to be with the Lord, but she lived 6 years longer and would just preach to her. And see, and she got the word from Patricia.
Yeah.
And not the word from me, which would breed rebellion.
Right.
You know, so if you're dealing with your husband, you're dealing with different people.
Yeah.
Like, Father, I can't fix my husband.
Right.
I lay him on your altar. I release him to you.
Yes.
Father, send somebody to him to minister to him.
Yes.
Which is that's just one of the things that's
in here. That's awesome. Well, what I love about the power to heal is it's not only going to help people receive the power for them to be healed, mm-hmm. but it's going to help them flow in that power
right.
of healing.
And see, the thing is, it's not a book of self-condemnation, self-examination. Is there anything I have done to bring this sickness on? Repent, mm-hmm. you know, repent for finances, repent for foolish spending, repent for any time you didn't tithe, repent for any time you didn't give an offering when God said to
right.
give an offering. Then you can go from there, you go into repent for not taking care of your body, not getting enough sleep, not getting the right food, you know, and things like that. And all these areas, because healing comes through repentance.
Okay.
You know, repent for saying those words. Repent,
right.
you know, and when you...
There's healing in our salvation. It's sozo, body, soul, and spirit. And we
right.
repent and come into salvation. So do we access all of the things of the kingdom by turning away from them and turning to him?
Well, we do one by one and
okay.
step by step, like
okay.
an onion. And, you know, because if, you know, and the thing is, our spirit man might be healed, but it takes a while for
right.
the soul.
Of
okay.
course.
And, but this, I mean, it literally walks you through any kind of traumatic experience. It tells you how to pray for the trauma. It tells you, it talks about unforgiveness. Because see, unforgiveness is a poison we drink that, you know, that we hope the other one gets sick.
Right, right.
And then, this is a really cool story the other day. And God tells me to say stuff, and I'm like, God, give them the grace to hear what I'm going to say. And I, you know, I try to be really sweet about it and whatever. But this one lady came up for prayer, and I let her in forgiveness and things like that. And I said, please, I don't want you to be offended, but you look a lot older than you are. And she goes, I know. And I said, God's going to give you a facelift because of all that he's done in your heart. Her whole face went totally, completely
wow.
sucked up. People were screaming, wanting to get in line for their Facebook.
Wow.
And the TV audience is going, I'm next,
oh,
you know.
Wow.
But her whole face totally sucked up and took off 20 years off
That's
of her
amazing.
Face.
That's amazing. Incredible.
And I mean, absolutely. And people were just like, oh my God, you know, and they're looking for Holy Ghost stitches or something,
right,
you know,
right.
but she was totally, completely healed. And see, when you truly forgive, it does give you a facelift.
Yes.
It does make you look younger.
Yes.
Well,
you
and
know,
all this junk in here, when it shows on your face.
One of the lies the enemy tells us about forgiveness is that if we forgive someone for what they did to us, it's like telling them what they did was okay. And that's not what forgiveness is. Forgiveness is removing the power of them being able to continue to impact us through those things.
It also says you will be forgiven.
Yes.
As you forgive.
As you forgive, yes.
And so we have to forgive whether they deserve it or not.
Right.
People, this one lady came up and I was getting ready to teach on forgiveness, and she goes, literally interrupts. She goes, I will never forgive him.
Wow.
I mean, screaming her guts. I said, okay, you come on up here. Let me minister to you. She got totally, completely set free.
Come on.
The next day, she goes into church, and people say, do you have a new hairdo? What kind of makeup are you using? You look completely different. She goes, actually, I forgave my husband yesterday.
Ex-husband. Amazing. Well,
I mean, there's power in this book.
And John says in I believe it's the third epistle, may you prosper and be in health as your
soul prospers.
And so much of what you're talking about is helping people see where in their souls, our mind, will, and emotions, we've come into agreement with actually things of death and darkness and disease and not
mm-hmm.
even realizing it.
And worthlessness.
And worthlessness.
Yep.
And so often we get ministry to our bodies, which is important, but
right.
sometimes the key is to get the breakthrough in the soul.
And that's why I like ministering the whole man.
Something you said, and I love that you minister to the whole person. Something you said before we went on air was about learning to demagnetize ourselves from sickness.
Mm-hmm.
And that's really everything you've been sharing, isn't
yes.
it? It's a way to push sickness away as opposed to draw it in.
Because like on the plane, this guy next to me a couple of days ago, and he's like, I'm like, okay, no weapon formed against me shall prosper. And if the enemy comes in like a flood, God raise up a standard. So in the name of Jesus, I just raise up a standard against those germs in Jesus' name. I mean, because I'm going to contaminate a container
right.
several times a week.
Right, exactly.
With all the disease
yeah,
on the plane
and
everything like that.
In the air on the plane,
and I mean,
right.
I'm only around sick people. I mean,
right, you're always ministering healing, to sick
yeah,
people, right,
you know,
right?
Not everybody's contagious, but you know, I'm yeah. always and sometimes I go and I'm like, thank you, Jesus, because I walk in divine health and I don't
Come
get
on.
Sick. And let me say,
Amen.
I don't get sick. That's not faith confession.
Right.
That is fact.
Right.
I don't get
That's
sick.
That's your history.
Mm-hmm.
Well,
which
Joan,
is awesome. It's great.
We've only got a little over a minute left, but what I'd like you to do is look into your camera. And as the Lord leads you, release that power to heal. One, for people to be healed in their souls and in their bodies. And then two, for them to be able to walk in the power of healing to minister
And definitely
to those
get the book, because it's a lot more than...
And they can go way deeper
yes,
into the book.
Yes, way deeper.
Absolutely.
So Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, we send the word of healing to everybody that is watching. Put your hand on your heart. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, I just curse any and all forms of trauma and the effect that stress has had on this body. In Jesus' name, I command health and wholeness. Father, I thank you that today you have opened up their spirit, man, to really go after you for more healing in here, because then when healing is in here, it will help, you know, heal all. I mean, you'll discover arthritis just literally not there anymore. So Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, I just curse every form of word curse that's been spoken over them. We renounce it. We cut those words off. You can wave your hand over your head, cut those words off, that they're blessed, they're prosperous, they're healed, they're whole. And Father, I thank you for equipping them with your power more than anything, with your knowledge, that they are anointed to heal the sick in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Amen. Woo-hoo! That's the power to heal from Joan Hunter. And I want you to know Jesus can heal you. Jesus will heal you because Jesus loves you with an everlasting love. He really, really does. Grab hold of that power to heal, to walk in the fullness of health, life, vigor, and vitality, and then operate in the power of healing to bear witness of Jesus everywhere you go.
You have gifts. God expects you to use them. If you need training to school your gift, log on to schoolofthespirit.tv. You'll find training in spiritual warfare, prophetic ministry, prayer, seer's ministry, writing, and so much more. Go to schoolofthespirit.tv today. You want to go deeper? Get equipped to overcome and walk in God's purpose for your life at Awakening House of Prayer's online campus. You'll experience an online family, preaching, teaching, and prophetic impartation for victorious living. We have over 1,000 members online, hungry for what God is saying and doing in the earth. Visit ahop.online today and join our family.
This has been a production of the Awakening Podcast Network. Jennifer LeClaire is the founder and owner of APN. Our heart is to inspire people and exalt Jesus with every broadcast. We're grateful for our advertisers and supporters that make these podcasts possible.